everyone. Welcome back. This is week two in our series, Rise Up. And I am Miss Kim, the Director of Family Ministry at Caw Prairie Community Church in Lenexa, Kansas. I'm super excited for you to join us this week, week two. We're talking about how Jesus rose from the dead. That was last week on Easter. We were super having a great time celebrating that. I hope you enjoyed celebrating that with your family and your friends. And so we're going to continue this month talking about all of the ways Jesus wants us to rise up in our faith. Before we start our lesson today, though, I want us to get our wiggles out and let's sing and dance to this fun song.
Of others' needs, love covers over shame. The kind of love God loves is we can turn your life around. That's what it's all about. Love apologizes first, love is last of all. Treats the bad like the best, and love gives it all. The kind of love God loves is we can turn your life around. That's what it's all about. Love lets the past up go. Love decides to trust again. Love never gives up. Love changes everything. The kind of love God loves is quick to turn your world around. That's what it's all about.
Break it down now.
We need to love.
Ever had to pitch a tent before? You know, it's kind of hard work, and if you've actually never done it before, it's kind of confusing and a little bit like a puzzle, like a big puzzle. And it's even harder if you don't have any extra hands to help you. So having a partner pitch a tent with you is usually the best thing because there's lots of poles you have to stretch out, and then there's like fabric that you have to put over the top, and there's usually like, well, this part has to connect to this part and then gets it together, and then you have to put it into the ground so it doesn't blow away. It's a big process, and it's much more helpful and easier when we have friends to help us. And today's Bible story shows us that knowing Jesus was alive after he was dead, they all thought he was dead, but then when they found out that he was alive, they knew he would have risen. That connected his disciples together, and it gave them a purpose as a group and to share this news with everyone. And it is an excellent privilege that we have as believers in Jesus Christ to share this awesome news with everyone. It's a hope that we put our faith and our trust in, and our, and we just, that's what we live with every day. And sometimes people wonder, what is it about you? What is it that's cool about you, inside of you, that I see? And it's that hope that we have in Jesus. And we want to share that message with everyone. But it's a lot easier if we have partners to connect to share that message with everyone. So before we get into our story, though, we're going to go on a little exploration again. I asked my friends if they would go explore around their house, around their yard, and I wanted them to find things in nature that connected to each other. Let's see what they came up with.
Thank you.
Thank you guys so much for sharing those pictures with us. It's so beautiful to see the different things that everyone finds. Don't forget, you can be in these videos too. Next week, we're going to have another exploration in nature, and I want you to be a part of it. So email me. It's super easy. It takes like less than 5 minutes to do these explorations, and I hope that you find some time this week to do that. So send me an email. It's running across the screen here, and tell me you want to be involved. I will get you everything you need to know. All right, so just like the leaves connected to the trees and some of the flowers that we saw were connected to their stems, there are lots of ways that Jesus allows for us as believers to be connected to each other. And we have a special message to share with the world about our risen Savior. And to do that, we need to be connected to each other to make that message spread further. All right. So I'm ready now to hear what Carl has to say. And I'm pretty sure you probably are too. So let's listen to the Bible story and all the other funny things that Carl wants to tell us today, right now.
Hey, Chicken Nuggets. It's me, Carl.
And I'm Vanessa.
Welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV. Hosted by Carl. Where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now, once again, welcome to Grow TV!
Woo!
What's wrong?
Woo!
Carl, what's happening?
I don't know. I'm just excited that it's Grow TV Day.
Oh, really? What do you have planned?
Literally nothing, but I can imagine something's going to happen that's going to entertain us.
Okay, how about I look through my hiking gear and see if there's anything that we can use today? Let's see. Oh, I know.
What is it? What do you have? Is it a parachute? Bouncy ball? Declaration of Independence?
Not even close. It was this.
Ah! Run away, run away. Why aren't you running away?
Carl, just relax. It's a bungee cord. I used it last time when I went camping to secure my things.
I'm glad you used a bungee cord, not a snake. But do most bungee cords have a piece of paper attached to them?
Huh? Oh, weird. I've never seen this before.
Well, let's see what it says. In order to find the big idea and learn about the Lord, the two of you must hold this bungee cord.
What?
It says in order to find the big idea.
No. I heard you. I just don't know what it means.
Well, yeah, me neither.
It sounds like if we want to find out the big idea, we both have to hold on to this bungee cord?
That makes no sense, but also makes perfect sense. Does that make sense?
No, but also yes.
All right, so what now?
I guess we talk about today's Bible story and see what we come up with?
That sounds like what they probably want us to do.
Who's they? Oh yeah, right. Let's open up the Bible to John chapter 20.
This is after Jesus overcame death.
That's right. And Jesus was about to come visit some of his disciples. They had gathered together and locked up the doors because they were afraid. After seeing what happened to Jesus, it was probably really scary to see what could happen to them too.
Yes, but then hey, guess who decides to show up? I said, guess who decides to show up? Psst, Vanessa, you're supposed to answer.
Oh, sorry. I thought you were asking them. My guess would be Jesus?
It was Jesus! The disciples were so happy to see Jesus alive and that he fulfilled everything that he said he was going to do. And they loved Jesus.
They sure did, but...
But? Don't say but. It's going so well.
I know, but there was one disciple that had doubts.
Doubts? What doubts? Doubts about what?
Well, the disciple Thomas had doubts that Jesus was, well, really Jesus.
Really? I guess that makes sense. He did rise from the dead. That doesn't happen too often.
Exactly. So Jesus proved to Thomas that he was who he said he was.
How did he do that?
He showed Thomas the marks on his hands and side from when he was on his cross.
Did it work? Did Thomas believe?
He did.
All right, go Thomas! Wait, what is that?
What is what?
Here in the rope, there's a word.
Oh yeah, it says Jesus.
Huh, Jesus. Why would it say Jesus?
Is it a clue?
Possibly, but what does it mean?
Well, the story about the disciples coming together, even though they are afraid, but they gathered to see Jesus so they could be with him.
Yeah, their connection to Jesus kept them together. It helped them with their belief.
And if this rope represents Jesus and we tie it to the story with the disciples,
I guess that means Jesus connects us to each other.
Carl, I think we figured out the big idea. Today's big idea is Jesus connects us to each other.
So let's say it out loud on the count of three. Ready? One,
two,
three.
Jesus connects us to each other.
Yes!
Well, I'm sure glad we figured that out.
Me too. Oh wait, I think there's something moving in my bag. What is that?
Let me see.
Ah! I gotcha. It's just a rope. See you next week, kids.
It's a bungee cord.
Bungee cord, oh. Okay.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of RoTV.
All right. Thanks, Carl and Vanessa. You know, guys, like I said last week, these stories are too good to only hear one time. So I have asked our friends to read the story for us again out of their Bibles. So if you want to go ahead and pause this video right now, grab your Bibles. If you don't have a Bible, email me. I will send you one. Everyone should have a Bible. There's so much good information in here that God wants you to know, and so we want you to have one. So grab your Bible, and in the Bible, there's two sections. There's an Old Testament and a New Testament, and we're going to be talking about the New Testament, which is where we learn all about Jesus. In the Old Testament, we hear a lot about the coming of Jesus, except for they didn't know who he was yet. And in the New Testament, we know who he is and what he did for us. So you're going to get to the back of the Bible. And in the one book of the Bible, there are lots of books inside of it. And we're going to look for the book of John. So it starts at the beginning of the New Testament, back of the Bible, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. So we're going to go to John, and then we're going to find the big number 20. The big number is the chapter number, and then the small number is the verse number. So we've got the book of John, chapter 20, and we're going to go with verses 19 through 31. So, and in my Bible, it's entitled, Jesus Appears to His Disciples. So John chapter 20, verses 19 through 31. So let's listen to our friends read it to us now.
John.
That Sunday evening, the disciples were meeting behind locked doors because they were afraid of the Jewish leaders. Suddenly, Jesus was standing there among them. Peace be with you, he said. As he spoke, he showed them the wounds in his hands and in his side. They were filled with joy when they saw the Lord.
Again, he said, peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I am sending you. Then he breathed on them, receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive anyone's sins, they are forgiven. If you do not forgive them, they are not forgiven.
One of the 12 disciples, Tom, nicknamed the Twin, was not with the others when Jesus came. They told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he replied, "I won't believe it unless I see the nail wounds in his hands, put my fingers into them, and place my hand into the wound in his side."
8 days later, the disciples were together again, and at this time, Thomas was with them. The doors were locked, but suddenly, as before, Jesus was standing among them. "Peace be with you," he said. Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and look at my hands. Put your hand into the wound in my side. Don't be faithless any longer. Believe."
"My Lord and my God," Thomas exclaimed. Then Jesus told him, "You believe because you've seen me. Blessed are those who believe without seeing."
The disciples saw Jesus do many other miraculous signs in addition to these ones recorded in this book, but these are written so that you may continue to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, in that by believing in him, you will have life by the power of his name.
Thank you, friends, for reading that for us. That's excellent. All right, guys, so Jesus' appearance to his disciples was a really, really big deal. It helped calm their fears. They had all witnessed his gruesome brutality that he experienced before he died. They witnessed him on the cross and they witnessed his death. They knew he had been buried in a tomb, and pretty much that was going to be the end of their story. And they were really upset about it. However, he came back, which we learned about last week, and some ladies, they had heard from the angel that he was back, and he even appeared to some of them, but then he appeared to all of them at one time, and that was really, really huge. And some of them doubted, and some of them were scared. I think I would be a little scared and nervous too, but in the end, it's what needed to happen, and God needed them to be connected to each other so they could understand what their job needed to be moving forward. You know, climbing mountains and pitching tents can be a lot of hard work, and not everybody who sets out to climb a mountain or even pitch a tent makes it, okay? It's not like they die. They just decide that it's too much work or it's too hard and they just can't quite make it to the top. Or maybe they're putting that tent together and they're like, oh, I'm done. This is so frustrating. I know I've been there before. So it's a lot easier when you have a team. Now, physically, someone could carry you up the mountain, I guess, but it's also really nice when people are there encouraging you, they're walking with you, and you do it as a team together to make it to the top of the mountain. And so this is another reason why Jesus wants us to be together to share his message, because it's just better that way. It's just easier that way. And he created us with each other to be able to share that message to everyone. So this brings us circle back to our big idea. Carl and Vanessa already told us, but let's say it together. All right, so we're gonna get a drum roll. All right, big idea. Jesus connects us to each other. Jesus connects us to each other, something to remember and something to use. You have people with you, your family, your friends, your friends from church, your pastors, your leaders, your small group leaders. We're all connected together to share the message of him with everyone. All right, everybody, that brings us to the end of our time today. Thank you for joining me this week. As always, don't forget, we have so many ways to connect with you. It's about our lesson, our big idea today, connecting with each other. And we have so many ways to connect with you. So get on social media, follow us. We've got all sorts of information, all sorts of fun things, all sorts of graphics that tell you what's going on. Our YouTube channel has tons of videos and lessons that you can watch. We also have on our website, where you might have found this video, but if you didn't, go to our website, go to the Children's Ministry page, and you're going to find our lessons that also have a craft and a little discussion at home discussion guide and another video that's a little shorter, cartoony kind of, and so that just tells the story in a different way. So be sure to check that out, because we have all of that for you. I also want to tell you that next Sunday, so if you're watching this video on April 11th, okay, 2021, next Sunday, April 18th is Kite Day, and it's our first annual Kite Day, and we're very, very excited. It's going to be super easy. You're going to bring a picnic lunch, you're going to bring your kites, and we're going to have lots of fun activities, games, kite flying, just different things for everyone to enjoy together. It's a time of fellowship. So we hope you come. If you go to kawprairie.org/kite-day, you're going to find information there, times, it's 11 to 1. You're going to also find a way to sign up. We'd love for you to sign up so we know how many people are coming. And then we also have our Heartland Day Camp. It's our annual day camp. We didn't get to have it last year because of the pandemic, but we're having it this year and we're super excited. It's a fantastic camp. You're going to love it. Go to heartlandcamps.org/kawprairie, and you're going to be able to find more information there and a way to sign up. Here is a brief promo video of some activities that you're going to be doing at Heartland Camp. Take a look. Doesn't that look like fun? Okay, you should sign up today because we're about halfway full. So make sure you get your spot. If you need a scholarship or help paying covering the cost, please let me know. We would love to help you. We just want you to come and have a great time and be with friends and learn about God. So, all right, guys, before we leave, we're going to go back to our memory verse. Remember, we learned it in sign language last week. So once again, you can find it in your Bible. It is Romans 10, verse 9. And we're going to go ahead and watch the video in sign language right now.
Romans 10, 9. If you declare with your mouth, Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved.
All right, everybody, that's excellent. Memorizing scripture is one of the best ways we can stay connected with God, and it's just a really great use of your time, and it's always nice to have that in your head if you ever need it. So keep working on that memory verse, and before we go today, I would love to pray with you. All right, dear God, thank you for bringing us together today. Thank you for raising Jesus from the dead, this amazing miracle that only you could do through Jesus, your son. And we praise you for that. Help us to stay connected with other people so we can share your message and spread your message of hope with everyone who needs to hear it. Bless us as we go through our week. And I ask all of this in the name of Jesus. Amen. All right, everyone, I will see you next week and enjoy this final song to boogie down to. Bye.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord.